Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, we are going to solve the following problem that I call probability of an inclusion. So this problem, contrary to the previous one I did, does not have any specific application in real life, but that looks like a fun problem to do. We just start with a set of n elements. And we are going, so that means that this set has 2 at the power n possible subsets. And we are going to choose uniformly at random 2 of those subsets. So, and I should precise here with repetition, meaning that if we call those 2 subsets A and B, then A can be equal to B. So they are both chosen uniformly at random from the set of 2 at the power n possible subsets. And the goal is to find the probability that A is a subset of B. So that means that what we want to compute is this probability, so probability that A is a subset of B. If we have, let's say, a set S here, and so we have, let's say I'm going to draw a picture of that, so maybe this is B, and A should be a subset. So I'm showing you a picture of this event. Be careful, have in mind that even if A and B are sets, they are not events in this case. The event we are looking at, it's not the event A or the event B, that's the event that A is a subset of B. This whole thing itself is a property and it's basically an event. So, the way to solve that is going to be like the previous video, to use a conditioning. So we need to condition on either a partition or a random variable. Here, if you think of the problem, something that would help is if we know how big the set B is, for instance. Indeed, if for instance B has n elements, meaning that B is equal to S, then A is obviously going to be a subset of B. If at the opposite, B is the empty set, then the only way that A is a subset of B is if A also is the empty set. So you see that clearly how many elements are in B is important here. And you see also that because the 2 sets are chosen independently, that means that if B has, let's say, k elements, that doesn't matter which k elements are in B, the probability that A is a subset of B, given that B has k elements, is going to be the same, okay? It's going to be the same, no matter which k elements you are going to choose. So that's kind of the motivation. So here, to solve the problem, we are going to, so the goal is to compute this. We are going to condition on, so maybe something I can call little c, that's going to be the cardinal of the set B. Okay, so using this, so notice that again this is a new random variable, and in fact something I should point out is that to solve this problem, that helps if you don't think of each of those 2 sets as one of the 2 at the power n set chosen uniformly at random, but if you construct those sets sequentially by just saying that one way to choose this set A uniformly at random from the set of 2 at the power n possible subset of S is exactly to proceed sequentially by looking at all the elements of S one by one, and for each of those elements you are going to flip a fair coin. If you get heads, you decide that this element is going to be an element in A, but if you get tails, then you decide that this element is not going to be an element in A. So looking at a sequence like this of independent coin flips of a fair coin, that is a way to construct those set A and B, and that's completely equivalent to the problem of choosing one of the 2 at the power n sets uniformly at random. So that's something I'm going to use at some point in the proof. So here, the conditioning here means that the probability of this event here is equal to, again, I'm going to write expected value of the probability of this event that A is a subset of B given this random variable C. Again, this conditional probability is not given an event, but given a random variable. So that's again a random variable. It turns out that the probability of this event is indeed the expected value of this conditional probability. Now, if you use the fact that C is a discrete random variable, with, in this case, finite range, clearly the number of elements in B can be anything between 0 and n, then you can rewrite that more explicitly and say that this is the sum for k equals 0 to n of the probability of the event of interest, a subset of B, given that C equals k, times the probability that C is equal to k. So now it turns out that this probability here is not very difficult to compute. And we are going to compute this one when we think in terms of choosing one of the two at the power n subsets uniformly at random. While to compute this conditional probability and the fact that A is a subset of B, that's to compute this conditional probability that we are going to use this kind of sequential approach where you can construct A step by step by keeping or rejecting independently with probability 1/2 each of the elements in S to construct your set A. So first step, what about the probability that C is equal to K? So probability that C is equal to K is exactly equal to, well, by definition, because everything is done uniformly at random, that's going to be exactly the total number of possible subsets of S that have k elements divided by the total number of subsets. So clearly the total number of subsets of a set with n elements, we know that it's 2 at the power n. So we need to compute this probability to multiply by a 1/2 at the power n that corresponds to 1 divided by the cardinal of omega. And omega, if the experiment is choosing one set, only not two, but one set uniformly at random, and then you have to multiply by the total number of possible subsets of S with k elements, and this is exactly the total number of ways you can choose k elements from a set of n elements that just n choose k. So here we have an n choose k. Then, how can we compute this conditional probability? So probability that A is a subset of B, given that B has k elements. So for this one, I'm going to go back to the picture. So I'm going to write in the picture that we have k elements in B. So that means n minus k elements that are not in B, that are in S but not in B. So now, when B is fixed, or it doesn't matter in fact if B is fixed or not, but once you have a set of k elements, what's important is that this conditional probability is only going to depend on k and not on the specific choice of B. But let's assume that you have a set B that is fixed and that has k elements. Then constructing A, choosing A uniformly at random but sequentially, that means that you can look at each of the k elements in B and decide whether those elements are in A or not. Those ones do not matter, because if some of the elements in K are not in A, that is not going to affect this event here. But what's important, so that A is a subset of B, is that we want those n minus k elements not to be in the set A. And so you just take one by one all those n minus k elements, and you just say that each of them, with probability 1/2 and independently of each other, are going to be not in A, with probability 1/2. And so that tells you that once your set B is fixed, there is a probability 1/2 at the power n minus k that indeed all those elements around B are not in A, which means that A is a subset of B. So eventually you end up with this conditional probability being equal to 1 half at the power n minus k. Okay, so now we are done with the probabilistic part of the proof. We use this conditioning on the random variable C to be able to write that. Then we use some basic combinatorics to find those two probabilities. And then the last step is just to replace those two expressions in the sum here and to compute. So that's just some basic algebra. So I'm going to restart here. So we said that eventually the probability of this inclusion is equal to, so we said the sum for k equals 0 to n of the product of those two terms. So we have a 1 half at the power n minus k, that's the conditional probability here. The unconditional probability here is 1 half at the power n times n choose k. And then, so computing this is not very complicated. And the result is kind of interesting because you get some very, very short, neat expression. So first observation is, again, same thing as usual, when you do those, when you want to compute those sum, look at what can get out of the sum. In this case, it's a sum over k. But you have here an 1 half at the power n times another 1 half at the power n that doesn't depend on k, that can go outside the sum, that gives you a 1 fourth at the power n in this case. So you get that this is equal to 1 fourth at the power n times the sum for k equals 0 to n of n choose k. And choose k, and I still have this, the only part left is this 1 half at the power minus k, which is the same as 2 at the power k. So I have this times 2 at the power k. So now how can we compute this? Well, it's not very difficult. In fact, it's of the form sum for k equals 0 to n of n choose k times a at the power k times b at the power n minus k. You are going to tell me, well, no, there is no b here. Well, the b, in fact, can be just 1. It's like you have a 1 at the power n minus k. If you do this, of course, 1 at the power n minus k is 1. That doesn't change the sum here. But now you have something really of the form a at the power k times b at the power n minus k by the binomial theorem. This whole sum here is equal to 2 plus 1 at the power n, okay? So eventually you get, I'm going to write here, 1 fourth at the power n times 2 plus 1 at the power n. And of course that simplifies, that gives you a 3 fourth at the power n. So eventually we get the final answer, 3 fourth at the power n. So just a little comment about the answer. So you see the answer is pretty nice. You have so this kind of neat, simple problem, and you see that the answer is very short, just 1 fourth at the power n. Something interesting also, which fits with our intuition, you see that indeed, if n is large, then there are many, many ways. I mean, if n is very large, then there are many different ways to choose a and b. It's not very likely that a is going to be a subset of b. And indeed, that's what we see in the formula. This goes to zero. Now, what's interesting is to see from our calculation that as expected, this probability goes to zero when n goes to infinity. But now we know that this goes to zero exponentially fast. And we know also the rate of convergence to zero. So final answer, probability that A is a subset of B if A and B are chosen uniformly at random from the set of subsets of a set with n elements, this probability is equal to 3 fourths at the power n.